pledge allegiance first.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, there's five and meeting of the Greensburg Board of Works is called to order. It's March 7th, 2016. At this time, please silence electronic devices. Roll call vote. Ashley.
Mayor Danielis.
Yes.
Carol Perkins.
Here.
Rick Enslaw.
Here.
Glenn Teddy.
Here.
And Darryl Ford.
Here.
Okay. Has all the board members received a copy of the minutes from last month? Is there any corrections? Not hearing anything, I'd like to have a motion to pass the minutes. So moved.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. No old business. Is Charlotte here? Bailey? I don't see her. Okay. Steve Garrett.
How's everybody tonight?
Good.
I'll try not to take up a lot of your time. I got several things. First thing I'd like to talk about is disposal of property. I went into the office and I got a bunch of old computers and stuff that's outdated. I'd like to get permission to dispose of them. And also what I have is old fire hose. What we do at Greensburg, we go by NFPA, which is National Fire Protection Association. Any hose over 25 years old, we do not use. But the hose did pass the hose test, and it could be used to other fire departments in the county that does not meet this requirement as supply lines. What I'd like to do is donate. I have both Washington Township hose and Greensburg City hose. I'd like to donate to the Adams Fire Department. And then I'd like to have Chris write up a letter that says to relieve us of liability on this hose. But I need approval from you guys to dispose of this property. Last year they took a bunch of the hose and they took it up to Annapolis to a fire training center and donated it to them. So I think if we can use it here in the county, I'd like to do that if it's okay with you guys.
How old are the computers? Just outdated?
Yeah, it's past the 25 years, but it has used past the test, but
computers.
Computers.
Oh, yeah, they're pretty old. I'm sorry.
25 years would be Commodores, wouldn't
it? Yeah, well, some of them computers might be in that closet 25 years.
Yeah. How many computers do you have?
One, two, three, four, five, about six computers, old ones. And they're the laptops, and I don't even know for sure where they come from, to be truthful.
You're just going to dispose of them?
Yes. And there's a cordless phone on there, too, and a printer, an old HP printer that I'd like to dispose of.
Well, like I talked to Steve, I don't have a problem with the hose. We got it checked at Washington Township on there.
Right.
But that did come with old engine four.
Old
engine four, so when they bought engine four, I know they paid for it. It loaded, so.
That's a good idea. Yeah. What we have, guys, coming up in a month is we're having recycling in for taking care of all the equipment, and they're coming directly to here. I guess they do that once a year. And the guys have been getting sheets, whatever, be shredded and shredded on site. So they do that once a year or twice a year. They come to here, so people are known. So we may get some more stuff to get me.
I'll make the motion that we commit the chief to get rid of the old computers, the fire hose that belongs to the Greensburg City Fire Department, the printer and the phone.
Second.
Okay, so the motion is that to get rid of the computers, phone, printer, on there.
And the fire hose.
And the fire hose from Greensburg Fire Department. Okay, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Passes, so please, we'll be able to get that, I want you to check the Washington Township, make sure that hose.
Yeah, I'll see them Friday.
Okay, that's right.
My next item is TARS for ladder six. We have Mitchell's on there now, they do no longer provide that TAR, so I got two quotes, one from Firestone, and the other one is Goodyear. And which one do you say is best to go with? Goodyear. The Goodyear tread meets, is closer to the Mitchell TAR than Firestone is. The Goodyear is $2,018.88. And the Firestone's is $1,753. But we's talking about the tread matching, and we prefer to go to the Goodyear TARs. It's more closer to the tread that's on the other truck. The TARs are 20 years old or 25? So they need to be replaced.
So this is in your budget, right?
Yeah. Okay. I have money in the budget to provide for them.
Okay. So it just basically,
yeah,
just kind of letting you know, I don't know if we had that motion from you, if it's already been in the budget or not, but I kind of wanted to know they have very long equipment that we're doing. So.
And they're both local bids. Walter TARs and 5-point TARs, so they use local.
Is this for all four tires at one time?
Pardon me?
Is it all four tires at one time?
Yeah, all four tires.
Okay.
So all four tires.
Tires are expensive.
Right, like, yeah.
No, that's no, four, fire, and okay. You're on what, replacing four of three?
Yeah, as a
okay.
So we should be in pretty good shape for a while, right, Troy?
Oh, that we did.
Troy's our maintenance guy, takes care of maintenance.
Well, it seems like it'd be important to match, I suppose.
Go ahead and make motion and go with the Goodyear so they're matching, or as close as we can to match.
Okay.
So the motion on the table is basically by the charge from Goodyear for $2,018.88. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Nay. Passes.
Next item I have is a generator for ladder six. And I have two bids on the generator. I have a Cummins generator. It's $9,800 plus $150 free. And the other company I have is $10,074.35. We would like to go with the Cummins generator. We will install this. It fits inside the panel of the truck by the pump, and that's one of the reasons why it's probably a little more expensive.
It's cheaper.
And it's actually, yeah, it's cheaper, but I mean, that's why the generator is around $10,000. We don't put it, you know.
Ladder six is the large truck.
The aerial truck. The aerial platform.
So it's a big one that we have.
Yeah.
So.
What happens?
Yes. As long, there's, the warranty is still good if we put the generator in. They still keep the warranty up. One of the guys asked me if we did it avoid the warranty. No, it does not. So our mechanic can put that in and save us a pretty good sum of money.
Yeah, we
Questions?
Like it's the lobbies.
Yes. Motion, please.
I would move that we approve the purchase of the condenser generator, the $9,800 plus chickens.
Second.
So our motion is that we will replace the generator with the Cummins generator for around $9,950. So all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It passes.
Okay, the next item is, and I can actually probably hold off on this, but I already had it on the book, is on-spot change for ladders two. It's a chain that goes up there and starts for snow and stuff, but being at the end of the year, I didn't know if you want me to bring this back later, or we decide now, we can buy it later on at the end of the year. That is your guys' decision. It's at $2,450. I don't know what it might be when you get ready to do October, or it's up to you guys how you want me to do this item.
How long has this been good for?
I don't know for sure about that.
But it's something that we, you were saying we need.
Yes. We should have had it. We actually had money for it the last time, but what they did is they got that rescue truck from Saudi Arabia or wherever they got it. They took it and put the chains on that truck instead of putting them on this truck.
You need chains on both, apparently.
Right. Yeah. So the other, the rescue one does have chain on it. This is a truck that does not have a chain. We also, we take this truck to Westport, Newport, anywhere in the county with a mutual aid agreement, no matter what the weather is, I mean, if they need this truck. So it is out in the rural areas.
Yeah, they do make a big difference. Ice.
So you had money in last, or they had last year, money in the last budget, last year.
Yeah.
And they bought chains, so is there money appropriated for this year?
I have the money, but I just don't exactly says on-spot change, but I have money in my budget that will pay where it's, it don't have to be.
For equipment?
Equipment, yeah, and in my equipment funds.
Basically, dogs.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It seems like everything goes up. It's up to you, how you guys want to do it.
Okay, I see here that it says that the installation is $730. Is that something that your guys could do?
No.
No, okay.
Yeah, we can't do that.
And then when it's so good at doing everything else, I don't.
Yeah, we can't save no money on this. This is pretty well.
I see.
But you wouldn't want to put them on now.
No, I'd probably find out right before the price is going to go up and get it done. I'll stay in contact with him, but that's why I didn't know if you want me to bring this back later or agree on it now so I don't have to bring it back.
I would agree on it now personally, but I would think that if you buy it, they would, whatever agreement, they would have to come back later and put it on with your, at your expense.
But if they don't, our candidates are heads off. It's not expensive.
So we only have one bid here?
Yes, there's only one company I know of around that does this, and it's in North Vernon, actually.
Okay.
The chains, we take the chains off, but we don't take the mounting stuff off. But when it weather breaks, we'll take all the chains off, hang them in the shed, and then we know when it's time getting ready, we mount them right back into there. Our maintenance guys do that.
Making sure we got our eyes crossed and our teeth dotted.
Yeah.
Since we do, I'll think of my idea. And since we have our eyes crossed, teeth dotted, we will make a motion that we approve approval and at his discretion as to when and how to bargain.
Okay, the motion on the floor is that we will purchase the on-spot chains for $2,450. Should be installed on Chief's readiness or whatever you want to get it done. And all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes.
Okay. Now I have one more item, and this one here, Rick's going to have to help me through. District 9 is a far area down south, and what we did years ago was District 9 bought a trailer, and they made it into a training trailer, and it is at for sale as fire department. They paid for it and everything, but the city of Greensburg carries the title of it because we insure it. I'd like to give this back to the sales fire department, but I have to have your permission to give the title back to them. But I have all the receipts where it for sales fire department has paid for all this, where they bought the trailer, 5-point tires, they bought equipment at Tops, and they bought a fire alarm, fire, the equipment went on there. They spent probably about $6,500. That they own the trailer.
Why do we have the title?
Because we provide the insurance for it. At so the they probably had to get the title to provide the insurance.
I think if we were not being different, use the cow of the trailer for something.
For a long time.
I guess that's why.
And we haven't had it at our fire station for a year, so I say, contact the chief for sales and said, since you have it, I'd like for you to take the insurance and take our name off the insurance, and so we don't have the liability if somebody gets hurt, it comes back on the city's insurance.
Counselor, so we don't have possession of it either?
Well, no, we don't. We haven't had possession of it for a year. We can use it, but we have not had possession for, I'd say, a good year when you, Rick, or longer. But they can keep it inside, so that's why they took it back.
Board's approval, the mayor would be able to sign the title and have it transferred back.
Is it something that can be used again?
Well, yeah, but we could go to for sales. It's for anybody in District 9 to use it.
Okay.
And we can use it, and we probably will maybe, but it's like we're not keeping it here, so there's no use, as far as I'm concerned, for the city to accept the liability of it. But if they want to do it, I'd let them do it. That's pulling it and everything. Might get hurt on it or anything like that.
I'll make a motion that we sign the title for sale. Fire department.
What's on the floor is we will sign the title over to for sales. Give me permission to sign the forms. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Passes.
And I'm sorry, I got one more thing I just found. I'm sorry. We have two old ice rescue suits, and we have old turnout gear, and I'd like to donate that. It's no longer good for us. I'd like to donate that to the water company, that they can use these ice rescue suits when they're working on leaks and stuff, and also they could wear our turnout gear. In the rainy days or winter months, it would help be better, and probably their Carhartt, it is water repellent. And I'd like to just donate that equipment to the water company if I could. It'd still be used out of it. It's no longer good as far as it expired. Well, I didn't know if I had to bring that
train. We just wanted to make sure
it's disposable.
Because I feel that they can use it. I mean, it's got some holes and they can patch it, but it's still kind of rubberized. And
yeah, there's nothing really on it. Back in inventory or anything. Serial numbers or anything.
Okay.
We're aware of it. That sounds like a real good plan.
Okay.
Thanks for your time.
Is that fast enough?
No.
15 minutes. Okay. Chief Bridges.
Megan, I'm going to kind of follow suit. This is not on the agenda, but this will be very quick. I'm going to introduce our new patrol officer, Casey Jones. who comes to us from North Vernon PD. He started here 2 weeks ago. Casey, if you want to go on up. He is a local Greensburg resident, went to high school here, grew up here. So, like I said, he should be turned loose on his own shortly to start patrolling. So, Casey Jones.
How are you doing?
And I didn't know if anybody had any questions for Casey before I sent him on his way, but.
Be safe out there.
Yeah.
Yes. You do that, you're good to go.
The only advice I have.
Next thing I have is for department promotions. I didn't know if you want to go one by one or on voting wise, or if you just wanted me to go through them all and then vote all at one and time, just kind of brief on what I'm doing here.
Yeah, let's do one at a time.
Okay. With the retirement of Captain Myros, there's going to currently be a captain's position open up in investigations. This time I'm bringing in front of the Board of Works to promote Mike McNeely, who has been with the Greensburg Police Department since 2005. If accepted, this will take effective March 20th, 2015, or I'm sorry, 2016. By that time, Captain Myros will be off the books and that position will be available. So I'm asking that Mike McNeely be promoted to Captain of Investigations.
I would move approval of the recommendation.
Second.
Okay, the motion is to approve Mike McNeely for taking Captain Myros' position. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Second. Last year, Bob Zaffe resigned from the Greensburg Police Department and he left open a position of Investigator 1, which is equivalent to lieutenant on the patrol side. I am recommending that Steve Barnes be promoted to the Investigator 1. Steve Barnes has taken on new tasks and has also agreed to take on further tasks, which I feel deserving that he be promoted to the Investigator 1 spot, and that will also become effective March 20th of 2016.
Question. So he currently is Investigator 2?
That is correct, which is a equivalent to a sergeant's position on patrol.
Any motion?
Move approval.
Second.
Good. Move Steve Barnes to Investigator 1 position. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay, so passes.
All right, the next one is with Mike McNeely being promoted to the, or leading the patrol to go to investigations, that left open a sergeant's position on night shift. I'm recommending that Wayne Davis be promoted to the rank of sergeant on night shift. Wayne has stepped up in the past 2 months and voluntarily went to night shift without anybody asking and has overtaken the responsibility and the hours of that position. So I'm recommended that Mr. Davis be promoted to sergeant all nights.
Will that take effect
through 20? I'm sorry, yeah, that will take effective March 20th, 2016.
Motion is to recommend that Patrolman Wayne Davis is promoted to the sergeant position effective March 20, 2016. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, so it passes.
Okay, and the last one, the promotion part, probation officer Stephen Hirschberger, I'm recommending that he be promoted to first class patrolman effective immediately. His actual start date was March the 1st, but since the meeting went until tonight, that's what I'm asking for that to be take effect. Mr. Hirschberger has actually exceeded our expectations and is doing a very good job currently on night shift. I've spoken with the officers that have worked with him, and no one has anything questionable on him. He's doing an excellent job for the city and police department. So my recommendation on him, effective immediately, be promoted to first class patrol.
So.
Second. Motion is Michael Hertzberg will be here. Steven. Okay, sorry.
Yes.
I don't have paper for me, so I don't know. So, to.
First class patrolman.
First class patrolman. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So passed. I'll be there.
I will actually pass this around and have each member sign. That way it can go into their personnel.
Orders.
And then next is for the hiring process. We conducted the interviews. There were six that we interviewed. And at this time, I'm asking the board for approval.
This time, I would like to hire two members from the list that we interviewed on, I think it was the 18th. Or, yeah, equal 18. Been six members, all of them good applicants. I would like to just at this time hire two people. So I know we got a number. You just tell me the numbers you want or what you think.
I would recommend that we hire, look at that list again, if I may, please. Is it number?
Yeah, I don't have it in front of me. I didn't print it off.
It's numbers two and number five on that list as pending their further qualifications for PERF and other.
So does everyone kind of agree with that two and five? Okay. At this time, I'd like to have a motion.
I make a motion that we hire number two and five as patrolmen.
Okay. Now, will they be probationary?
Yes. Yes, they'll be probationary patrolmen for 1 year.
Okay. Second?
Second.
Okay.
Could I ask
yes.
a question?
I'm sorry, go ahead.
So then, the way we rated the, or ranked, not rated, ranked these officers or potential officers, is that list going to remain active for X amount of time, a period of time, or we would revisit that?
I'd say I want to first make sure these two guys get through their per physical and through all the paperwork and stuff, but also make sure they accept it. We may have to come back, and I want to, you know, keep our list for the time being, and then maybe in July, is that when we kind of figured out that maybe we'd be safe to hire somebody, because I wanted to make sure that all the monies were off the books and everything on that. We could open it up, but we could interview these guys again without them having to go through the whole process again. If we need to. So.
So roughly 3 months.
Do I hear a second?
Yeah.
I got it. Okay. Motion on the floor was offer.
Right.
Unconditional offer for two and five this time. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. We have those two.
Okay, and the last on my list is also a recommendation for disposal of equipment. Mainly, I believe I have eight desktop computers, two laptops, and a old printer, and then phone equipment. With the desktop computers, those were computers that were used in the squad room and in the 911 dispatch center. So those computers actually ran 24 hours, 7 days a week due to our schedules. So they are needing to be disposed of. I've already spoken with our IT guy, and he's going to make sure that the
hard drives,
thank you, will be removed and disposed of properly due to the confidential information that's in there. Those will be disposed of properly. The old copier that we have, that's been passed down, I believe, through three departments. So it's on its last leg. And then the phone systems, our phone systems that we had several years ago, and with the upgrade to the 911 center, plus everything with the courthouse and the sheriff's department, we are all now on one phone system. So all of our phones that we have are of no use. So I don't know really what else to do with those other than to dispose of them. And those would all also be brought over for City Hall to be disposed of during that time period. So.
Brought to City Hall to be disposed.
That company that's going to come in and actually dispose of it.
I was thinking it was only the paper.
We're shredding electronics, or not shredding it, but
gotcha.
Getting rid of it, passing them.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So are they, all this equipment in bad shape, or is it?
I mean, I don't know if once the hard drives are wiped clean, if somebody else in the city can use them. Now, the monitors, no, because like I said, the monitors were on 24/7, and so they've got some of the stuff burnt into the screen. But I mean, computer-wise, like I said, it depends on if anybody within the city would maybe need a hard drive to use. I'm guessing they're in good shape.
I would think the hard drive would be destroyed.
Yes.
Unless, like I said, you want to buy a hard drive for them, but I don't
know. I think we just get rid of that.
Okay.
Find you can have somebody that they're just going to store.
Dispose of them properly.
Okay. Do I have a motion then?
I would move that I give authorization to dispose of the computers, the copier, and the phone system.
Second. Okay. Motion is to give authorization to get rid of the computers, copiers, and phone systems that needs to be rid of. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? It passes.
Thank you.
Chief, can I ask you one question?
Yes.
How long will it be before the officer, the offers are made to the
I will probably make phone calls in between the Board of Works and City Council meeting. Just for the simple fact, I want to probably go back to the police department, go ahead and get them signed up for perf medical, because it takes a little bit of time. So the sooner we can get them up to Indianapolis, the better. So I'm gonna make phone calls tonight, because like I said, they were all aware that tonight was the meeting night too. So I don't want to leave everybody hanging.
And will you contact the other ones as
yes.
well?
Yep.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bailey, would you like to come up?
Hi, public domain. I had a client.
No problem.
Good evening. Hi, I'm Charlotte Bailey. I am the Sheriff's Secretary of Delta Lambda Chapter in Greensburg, Delta Theta Tau. And I'm asking permission for April the 16th. For the use of for 5K that we have run. This is be our fifth year servicing, doing this. I've spoken with Brendan, and I've emailed Dan, and I think I emailed Mark, and they've all corresponded with me, and they know the date. So April the 16th for the Delta Theta Tau Delta Dash 5K. It will start at Greensburg High School, go on to Central, back to Big Blue Avenue, to Montgomery, down to Breedland, I think that's it, and then back onto the county Road and then back on Central to the end of the, end at the front of the high school. Last year, we made, just from that, we made a little over $3,000. And last year, Delta Theta Tau sorority, we had over $9,900 that we put back into Decatur County. So every dime that we make for anything that we do, we have a Vera Bradley Bingo coming up on March the 31st. And we're making a lot of money and giving it right back to Decatur County. Asking permission.
Gentlemen, do you have any issues with?
Sounds like a good idea.
County have been checked with on their part of the
route. Yeah. And I talked to Mark and emailed Mark.
I'll talk to Sheriff.
Sheriff Department, no. They never usually, it's usually Brendan helps me.
Move approval.
Okay, the approval to for the run the 5K starting out at the high school.
Yep.
For Delta Tau. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Okay, thank passes. You, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Good. Okay, Jeff Smith.
He's back.
You should receive a copy from on addendum number 2, task order number 15-1. It's on wastewater treatment plant engineering. Things I'd like to add to the engineering. Basically, addition of variable frequency drives for the new pump station, a line that returns filtrate back to headworks. Also, we have a little bit of chemical building we'll be building, and we're trying to figure out how we're going to get fire protection, or if fire protection is needed on that. And just some other engineering things we need to do for fund-related services. Basically, it gets on my long-term control plan and my fossil removal that we've been working on upgrades. You should have also received a small spreadsheet shows that by now from the existing from the Honda tip, and that was negotiated back in 2006 or 2007. Okay, I had some funds left over that can be used for plan improvements only. This does put that requirement as plan improvements. So what I did is right now I've got $695,106.49 in that balance as we pay down and as additional future contracts for construction stuff to be paid out of that. I'll still have around $21,000 left in that balance. That doesn't have to go through the SRF or any other loan payment. And basically, the way that the TIF bonds were written, it had to be used at the wastewater treatment plant or related improvements to the wastewater treatment plant. So that's why I'm asking you to go ahead and approve the contract and then also approve that you've taken out the TIF bond and that I have it in the
Any
well, I think I understand the funding of it. I think.
Yes.
So, in terms of relying on you and relying on Dan and others that have looked at this, that the need is legitimate, that and therefore I don't have any questions. I don't know enough to ask anything.
Well, part of it is from a long-term control plan. We are under agreed order with IBM. We have to do certain things on that long-term control plan. The other part of it is for phosphorus removal, which will be coming up in 2019. which sounds like a long way off, but it's not a long way off when normal construction projects this size, gonna be a year and a half probably before it starts. From the time you put a shovel in the ground, those types of time, get ready for that.
Yeah, we gotta design first.
Yeah.
Related question, I think.
Okay.
Maybe not, but you mentioned the agreement with IDEM and so forth.
That's a long-term control plan. The other agreement I have is a nickel.
Right.
That one I'm putting on right now.
I'll wait on that then before we get this one set.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a different group. That's a different group.
All right.
If you have any questions, Randy Rodriguez is here from Strand. She'll be happy to engineer. She'll be happy to answer. She can answer the questions a lot better than I can, as far as the engineering is concerned.
I don't want to embarrass myself and ask any question. I don't have any irrelevance to it at all.
Anywhere that has more letters in my name, I'm going to depend on you.
Okay. Need a motion?
I would move authorization of the engineering design, engineering services outlined by Mr. Smith.
That's second.
I'll second.
Okay. So the motion is to accept the motion is to make design requirements for the sewage plant. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So passed.
And I'll bring up hard copies of the motion. The next question.
So last week or last month, the ordinance was to pass a first reading, I assume, at the council to notify us about that. And now you are asking that we put this on hold, and the reason for you wanting to be on hold is?
Okay. Basically, I have received a tentative approval from EPA, which I've been waiting for since September 2013, my first bill of 8 ago. Then in September 2015, I resubmitted because they couldn't find the orange notebook, that's him. So I resubmitted, it went high priority. She sent back a letter to an email that the lady that reviewed it said, yes, it's tentatively approved. Now it has to go up chain of command and they have to sign off on it. So I want to see that final letter before I go final passage. The reason I started this was because after 2 years, I called the Indiana Department of Environmental Management and said, I've been waiting on EPA for 2 years on this. I'm tired of it. I need something so I can change, you know, put the ordinance together, get it passed. She said, well, go ahead and pass it. If the EPA comes back and says you need to do it, you'll just have something else. You'll have to amend that. So I figure I can wait another week, 2 weeks, come back to the first next month, a month after that. There's no amendments to what I need to do on my ordinance. I won't have to, you know, won't have to amend it. If I do, I can take that time, get it passed, and get it started. Region 5's had a little problem. Anything else, gentlemen? Thank you very much.
Okay. On the list is Smart Clocks the Cooper.
No back porch.
Good evening. I don't know if you're all familiar with it, so I'm going to give you a little bit of background. About 3.5 years ago, there was a call for projects for highway safety improvement funds. We applied through INDOT for a federal aid project to replace signs, regulatory warning throughout the city. Anything that was in a condition that would be substandard. At that time, we were directed, there was kind of an unwritten rule that they had a $300,000 invisible ceiling. That was as high as they'd go. So when we put our grant together, we applied for $299,700, which is what they awarded us. Throughout development, the number of signs and the quantities increased a little bit.
more than was anticipated because we had a lot of signs that didn't pass the repl reflectivity requirement. So we were anticipating construction of 211, and when we went to submittal to INDOT, we thought it'd be 227. They opened bids last Wednesday, and the low bid came in at $282,000, which left up picking up the tab for about $80,000 more than we anticipated on the city's share, because we have to pay 100% of everything above the funding. So I spent most of last Thursday, after discussions with the mayor, groveling at the feet of everybody I knew at INDOT, and was informed Friday that they would grant us another $90,000. So what you have in front of you is a supplemental contract, and if you'll see the amount on page two, it says $359,512. That should cover us for everything on the overage of the budget. We still have to make our match of 10% of the 282, so we're going to have to run check 28-2, which we had anticipated most of that anyhow. And those funds are covered. But with this, this will help us and not make Dan squirm if we have to figure out where we're going to get the rest of the money we needed.
So the signs have been ordered, or they're about to be replaced, or they're going to be replaced?
They will be done through contract. We had a full set of plans. The city of Greensburg has been split up into 31 separate areas. We actually inventoried each and every warning and regulatory sign throughout the city.
Okay, so wasn't this brought up once before?
When we started the project, yes.
I thought I saw something over there recently. Okay.
This is how long it takes to get through development. Actually, two letters. Well, we have not been informed of when our pre-con is yet, so we don't know when the pre-construction meeting will be at Seymour. Then we will actually meet the contract, and then we will get a schedule for what he anticipates to get through the summer to get the signs replaced.
Well, I'd say good job getting extra money.
Thank you.
Anytime you can get $300,000 worth of signs for 28 grand, you jump on it in a heartbeat.
Great groveling.
So the contract that you have in front of you, the way it's set up, it requires three signatories. I guess you can flip coins as to who wants to sign. I would probably say leave one for Dan, and two of the four remaining need to sign it on page three. I believe they're set up for counties is the way their contracts are done, because normally there's three county commissioners.
Only see three signatures.
Left side under LPA, City of Greensburg. It's got print, name, title, signature, and date. There's three signature lines. So you guys can figure out who wants to sign it.
Is there further discussion needed? Move approval of the supplemental contract. Number 8249-14-320-824.
Second. I have a motion to pass supplementary number 1, EDS number 8249-14-320-824. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thanks. Is there anything else, Mark?
On the back of that, Ashley, they need your attestation, and they need our DUNS number. This came in late Friday, Chris. I didn't get it past you, but it's a boilerplate NDOT. I know you reviewed our complex, but this one's pretty simple and straightforward. But I'll let you take a quick glance.
Got it.
Thank you.
Good job there, Mark. I'd be sweating a little
off. It made you sleep easier over the weekend, didn't it?
Okay, next, we need to talk about workman's comp member. We had one meet on the 18th and talked about a workman's comp about extending his time another 6 weeks through the Board of Works. Any comments? comments, or?
I would move approval for the request extending his leave for 6 months.
Second.
Okay. The motion is that we'll extend his leave for another 6 weeks.
And he will come in and talk to us after that 6 weeks and let us know where he is.
Yeah, because we talked about, yes, we need to.
So part of the motion.
So that he'll be back in to come talk before the board again and tell us how he's doing on that. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. I do need to have an executive meeting with you guys sometime. Reference to, we could probably do this with him also, and with the budget, talk to you about the budget, what we're doing at this time. I didn't know if anybody had anything like the 24th or the 21st of March.
21st is better.
Okay.
No. What time?
I don't care. 6, 5.
24th would be better than for me.
Okay.
What Tuesday?
Yeah, no.
Okay, 5:30?
24th.
Work. Okay. Shut that down. Any other comments from the board? Okay, any comments from the crowd? Well, do I hear a motion adjourned?
So moved.
Second?
Amen.
Okay.